This is one of the more curious films in the Mitchell and Kenyon collection. The film party travelled to Airfield Lodge in January 1902 with the intention of making a feature film on the King's horse, Ambush. They were to be disappointed, however, as Ambush was unavailable, and thus contented themselves filming a variety of shots. A picture of the horse and images of themselves entering the lodge on a hackney carriage. The camera crew can be seen in the distance waving from the cab. Then, as they jump down, there's a wonderful example of self-advertising from the Thomas Edison Company, as one of the party is carrying a camera case with Edison pictures on the side. Here we see some views of the stables, some of the stable lads, and a distant shot of a horse exercising. Most remarkable of all is this footage of a mock horse race in which the stable lads and camera crew attempt to reenact Ambush's famous victory in the Grand National in 1900. The crew are seen jumping and falling over the fences in a sequence that would not likely have been part of the final edit, but was purely an example of tomfoolery on the part of the camera crew. They returned on January the 21st and finally captured Ambush on film. Seen here being led out of the stables by his trainer. He is identifiable by the distinctive white marking on his face and his close-cropped tail. This film was being made in anticipation of the 1902 Grand National steeplechase, for which Ambush was the favourite. Ambush had won the race in 1900, but owing to the death of Queen Victoria, Edward withdrew all his horses from the competition in 1901 as a sign of mourning. Makes another appearance. Sadly, this film is the only footage that has survived of this famous horse, the earliest on record of a Grand National winner. Alas, the film was never exhibited at the time. A fortnight before the race, Ambush unfortunately suffered a serious injury and had to be withdrawn. Of the sports day at Queen's College Cork was not necessarily taken to mark a sporting occasion, but more to record the society that was on show. Thus, we see just glimpses of the sporting action interspersed between shots of the crowds enjoying the proceedings. a local comic to the left who laughs and gestures to the camera, perhaps after partaking of too many of the refreshments available. The desire of the film crew to shoot the crowd as well as the event was highlighted in the Cork Examiner, which wrote, "A word of warning. The exhibition's cinematograph operator will take a series of snapshots in the gardens today, not necessarily in good faith, but with a view of publication later on. His idea is to take interesting pictures which will be shown subsequently to larger audiences. Ladies, you've received due notice. Don't blame us if you don't look pretty. See that your hats are on straight and wear a bewitching smile. We have always said that you are beautiful. Don't give the cinematograph man a chance of finding us out."